If I can take a quick moment to be sincere, and then I'll go back to being an asshole. Know that I appreciate this. This isn't lost on me. I didn't have dreams of grandeur getting into comedy. It's overwhelming. Thank you for coming out. I know that eventually this will come to a crashing halt. I'm not gonna stop saying awful things. Eventually I'll say the one thing where it's like, oh, there goes his career. Wow, he thought you could say that, huh? I actually wrote a career suicide note. Would you like to hear it? Okay. Dear Jews. That's all I've got so far. But it's, right now people are like, oh fuck, he's doing it. Here we go, got it. This started out strong. Burn some bridges. I don't meet fans after the shows, mainly because I don't want to. For good reason. I have a very large social media presence to pat myself on the back about things that don't matter. On average, I receive around 1,200 death threats a week. Yeah, no, it's fun standing up here. Sorry, I don't want to shake hands with the guy that wrote die, fag, die, hashtag you're a fag. I'm a fan, I was kidding. I apologize sincerely about ticket prices. But you have to understand, I can't risk performing in front of the type of people that can afford $10. And as hard as that joke is for some of you to swallow, there's other people in here that are like, I actually appreciate him saying that. Because I was like, this is way too much money. But now that I think about it, yeah, I wouldn't stand in front of those monsters either. You can get lucky and find a 10, like, oh, I'm gonna murder someone. People accuse me of everything online. Misogynistic, I get that. No, I'm just a male comic with dumb jokes. If I was a female comic, the jokes would be completely opposite and empowering, and the crowds would be a lot smaller. Yeah, because you don't support your own, ladies. That's on you. Racist? I don't like hearing that. I never, never use the N-word into a microphone anymore. I'm so aware of social issues, even when I'm home alone doing laundry, I won't use the word colors. Yeah, I do a load of whites and a load of darkies, and that's it. That's it. Because I want to be on the right side of history. My parents live in the same house. Just to point out what kind of maniacs some of you are. Every day of my parents' life, somebody will ring the doorbell and just be standing at the door and just like staring at my mom. And my mom will be like, yeah, I'm his mother. And they'll be like, is he gay? And then they run away. Not gay. I have a girlfriend. Not by choice. I blame Hollywood for ruining every relationship that I've ever been in. What you don't realize is how negatively they affect your relationships. Everyone's aware of the liberal media bias in the news, but what about the way they portray couples in every sitcom where there's a dumb husband chasing his wife around the whole episode like, I want to have sex, and she's never in the mood. And they just hammer that stereotype home that men always want to have sex and women never do. Let's get this out of the way right now. Women want to have sex way more often than men. I assure you, ladies, this is not the perspective you're going to enjoy. I don't know if you're new to my comedy or not. I have a very gender-specific slant that I ride pretty hard. Because the reality is, whether you want to admit it or not, no man's ever loved you more, been more physically attracted to you than he was the first time he had sex with you. And from that moment, it goes down. Okay, now don't look at him right now and make the evening uncomfortable. Is that true? And then he has to be like, oh, no. I'm pretty sure he's queer. I don't care what he says. It's true 100% of the time. How fast it dives is case by case. It doesn't have to fall off a cliff immediately. We've all been there when it does. Can you be happily married for 50 years? Of course you can. But know that for him, every time you have sex, it's going down a notch. Men die 10 years earlier because we fucking want to. Don't make him feel inadequate. Don't challenge his drive. I'm with the only guy in the world that doesn't want to have sex all the time. No, you're not. When I'm in a relationship, I can go 2 to 3 weeks without thinking about sex. When I'm single, I need to masturbate twice a day before I step outside, or I will sexually assault someone. I assure you, his drive is fine. It's the product that's sour. Is that too harsh? Your snatch has spoiled. Is that softer? And I know what your response should be. Well, then maybe you shouldn't be in a relationship if that's how you feel. But that's not how I'm wired. I like to be in a relationship at first. And I won't cheat on you, and I won't break up. So every time I fall in love, I'm like, fuck, here goes 3 years. I don't even understand how real dating sites exist. Whenever I'm in a relationship, my dream scenario is that I come home from work, open the door, and catch her blowing someone. That's not a big laugh. But notice there are people laughing. Do you know why? Because for the first time in a long time, there's guys in here going, I'm not alone. That they can understand that twisted logic. They just come home, open the door, and there she is, just, you're home early, and you're like, oh shit, you can't do that, I'm out of here. Yeah, no, we don't even talk anymore. I'm just magically happy again. Do I get that? Nope. Every time I open the door, there she is. Hi, I'm not blowing anybody. Where should we go for dinner? Gun range? I'm teasing. I've never drugged a woman. I feel it's good if you're a comic and can say that truthfully. Sure, if my girlfriend asks for Tylenol, I'll grab Tylenol PM, but that's only because I want to watch TV by myself. I don't think I go to jail for that. If you've ever convinced your man to go to a Halloween party or a costume party of any sorts, and he's dressed up, know that he's cheated on you. You're welcome. Now, what you do with that information is up to you. It's just a theory I'm working on, but I think it's foolproof. Because this is how this conversation should go if you're in a relationship with a man who's never cheated on you. Hey, honey, next week we're gonna go to this funny Christmas sweater party. Fuck that. What? Nope. No, I'm not. I'm an adult. I'm gonna stay home and watch TV and then go to bed. That's what a man says that has never cheated on you. A man that's cheated on you goes, oh, I owe her. Yeah, that sounds fun. Let's go. I only like this joke because I know there's a guy in here right now going, what the fuck was that about? Out of nowhere.